On the next presentation,
I'd like to introduce Mr. Hollywood Bundesrea. And we are very glad that you accept our invitation and came to the seminar. And dear professor, please, time is yours.
Thank you. Before to start my presentation, I would like to express my thanks to the organizer of the seminar, especially Jan and Piotr, and professor, for this kind invitation and support of my travel from Armenia, the country that is more than 3,000 miles away from Europe, but considering like a neighbor country. And I'm happy that I have this possibility to present now the results and some overview of the work of our group. There is an international group. We have three Armenians and Marian Marciniak, professor from Poland, and we cooperating long time and working in different directions related to the microwave and photonics. And today I would like to speak about this microwave photonics. What is this? Before to start, I would like to show it is our university. It is 70 Yas University in Armenia, Technical University. And here is Yerevan, capital of Armenia. And you see the Bible mountain Ararat, what is the symbol of Armenia. In Japan, we have Fujiyama, we have two. But it's not function of Gauss. I think mine's sharp. And unfortunately, it is in Turkey, from the Soviet time. And if you come in Armenia, we can only see from the far, but not to go close. And I would like to say that here is the Armenia. Here is a small country. And it is only the part of Armenia before it was bigger. But now it's very small, 3 million population, very ancient country. We accepted the Christianity 1,700 years ago. This is the church operating, one of the churches. We have many these type of churches. It is 7th century church, what is built in that time. And you can enter and to see how it's prepared. Now my presentation. You know what is the microwave communication, and you know about the relevant devices, that they are antennas, bulk metallic sound systems, etc. Sometimes it's very heavy. When you are flying, you would like to have on a plane much more light construction, but not metallic. And now is coming the possibility to merge the optical communication with microwave communication. But before to say about this merging, we can say the advantages of microwave communication is mobility. We can have mobile communication. But when we are speaking about the fiber communication, we are thinking about the fixed communication. That means it will be merging, that we can use the advantages of both of them. But the question is much more deep. You see that if we consider optical communication, there are specific devices created for optical communication. They are electro-optical devices that transfer electric current to the optical field. And we have also optical fibers for the transmission. And we have opposite devices that transfer the optical field to the electrical current. And that means we have optoelectronical devices and full optical devices or some parts. And here is, for example, amplifiers. It can be electro-optical amplifier. It can be full optical amplifier, like erbium doped fiber amplifier. That means we have a lot of some new devices in photonics, in optics. And of course, you know about the microwave devices, that they are bulk from metals, etc., and electrons. And I would like to give my opinion what means the microwave photonics. From the Wikipedia, you see what is the photonics. What is operate with a light, it calls photonics. But there can be electro-optical, opto-electronical devices. All this is photonics. But microwave is the range of electromagnetic wave, centimeters or about 10 centimeters. And microwave photonics is, that means merging, mutual actions of both techniques, what we can to take advantages of this. And I would like to show some applications of these advantages, and maybe it's not full, but remain what I can found for this presentation. For example, optical fiber link to transport microwave signals. If we have antenna, we can have a remote antenna by using the fiber optics links. It is very important for the military applications, very important for the big ship applications, where is antenna, where is your receiver or transmitter. Light modulated of microwave frequency is now being investigated in medical imaging. This is under the investigation. And the emergence of microwave photonic signal generation processing. It is very interesting one that if we can transfer the electrical signal to the optical domain, we can use the recirculating loops, fiber break gratings like filters, and optical amplifiers, very wide range, very low noise, that we can use the advantages of optical devices by using the transferring microwave to the optical domain. An implementation of optical anodic to digital converters, photonic time stretch, we can make time delay for the... In microwave, it is not easy to have big time delay because it will be some line prepared from the metals, etc. But in optics, it's very easy because if you are a loop or you are a long fiber, you can have very big time delay of your signal. It is like buffering, etc. And arbitrary waveform generation. The use of photonic technique to generate microwave millimeter waves. It is possible, and here is connected the terahertz generation. What about, we can speak if we have a time for the second part of my presentation. That means by using the optical domain, we can, from photonics, by heterodyny, that to have two wavelengths of laser, obtain the terahertz. That means it is heterodyny. And of course, we can use the electronic, like GaN diodes, microwave. And this is merging, because terahertz is between the infrared and microwave. It is merging of microwave photonics is very productive and prospective. And we expect that there will be breakthrough, and we will have terahertz sources and receivers very suitable for application. And also the radio over the fiber, well known for you, that when you are speaking with your mobile phone to the far telephone or mobile phone, sometimes you are connection by the fiber, because fiber possibilities is much more larger than microwave and cheaper, and we can using it very well. We don't know about this, but we are using this every time when we are speaking in other countries, etc. Here is, I would like to say that I see a lot of young scientists, that the educational perspective of microwave photonics is a little bit complicated, because the photonics and microwave, it is separate subjects in the university. And only now we have some possibilities to teach students microwave engineering and photonics, but very slow. And this is practitioners with the mix of background physicists and electric engineers can work in this area, because microwave needs electromagnetism, optics a little bit another one, and there is a semiconductor. And that means it is a little bit complicated subject, needs a wide range of knowledge. Maybe it will be one magister students of electro engineers, and after continue to the photonics, and eventually it will be microwave photonics specialist. Now I would like to say that for the microwave photonics, the key device is electro-optical transferring. That means how to transfer or some influence of electrical signal on optical. And the well-known device is Mach Zehnder modulator. This is the optical waveguide divided on two parts and joined after some distance. And here is metallic plates, and you can change the permittivity of the substrate, that you can change the permittivity under one or both waveguides. And here is the schematic of the Mach Zehnder interferometer or modulator. When you put the signal, it divides the optical signal in two parts, and one when have delay, they will meet in a phase or counterphase, opposite phase. That means you will have signal or zero. It is a very good modulator. It's used for the modulation, but it widely used in microwave photonics, but there is an important area where they cannot operate by the reason of low conversion efficiency. What means that the signal of microwave you apply to the semiconductor or nonlinear material will be very high voltage, some volts or more, and it will be converted and interact with optical wave. I would like to say what is interested of our group. It was how to make this electro-optical conversion efficiency, how to increase. We need increase conversion efficiency when we have very small microwave signal. And we coming to the very interesting task to have a microwave receiver with very small signals, but using the advantages of optical signal processing. And here I present the block scheme, block diagram of conventional microwave receiver. It is super heterodyne. And you see the antenna, here is the amplifier, mixer, local oscillator, filter, intermediate frequency amplifier, the modulator, and another amplifier. And what is here the question? The question is why we would like to make it for microwave photonic, but not left as a microwave device. It is a well-established scheme of microwave receiver. And when we go to the 10 gigahertz or 200 gigahertz, in this case, this local oscillator gives stray radiation to the antenna. And your receiver radiates. When it's your receiver radiates this microwave heterodyne frequency, you have two very strong drawbacks. It is interference with neighbor radio devices. It is very bad thing when you have many radio devices on the airplane or from on the ship. It is in the military very often we have planes with many receivers and transmitters. And in this case, you have a big drawback of interference. And the second one is much more bad, that localization determination of covered radio receiver. It is by its stray radiation. That means if you have a receiver, you are thinking that you are not transmit a signal, but the local oscillator transmit some signal, very small. And the enemy can have a very sensitive receiver and to know where is your station, where is your receiver. You are thinking that you are not transmitting, all is okay, but they know where you are. And they are also using the robbers in USA, when they would like to rob the bank, they would like to know on what distance are policemen with car and how many minutes they have for the robbing. And they have a very sensitive receiver and locate the position of policemen by their receivers only, and using this. And for this purpose, that it's drawback, It was a suggestion to make some filters prevent the radiation of local oscillator, but they operate very bad. It's not so good. And the cardinal solution is to move to the optical domain. And we are coming to this microwave optical receiver. What is here? Here you have antenna, microwave antenna. If you have a good modulator, sensitive modulator, because the signal is coming is very small, you will have very good modulator and high efficiency. And if you have optical source, in modulator you will have interaction. Your signal will be transferred on the optical domain, and you can use the photonic signal processing. Here is the spectrum, if you know that. Here is, for example, carrier of 60 gigahertz, it is microwave. And when you are using the optical carrier of laser, it is 200 terahertz. And you have now the side lobes of amplitude modulation, where there is a microwave and low frequency signal. And here is, you can eliminate by fiber break rating the carrier, and to amplify the signal, and to obtain the signal from the optical domain. It is the cardinal solution. In this case, you have no microwave local oscillator, you have no stray radiation, no one can know that you have a receiver working on 60, for example, gigahertz frequency range. And advantages of microwave photonic receivers are listed here. The deliverance from parasitic radiation, deliverance from interference of mirror channels, it is superheterodynamic drawback, photonic processing of microwave signal, immunity to the optical part of receiver from the electromagnetic stray radiation, and low weight, low power consumption, and durability. All is okay, that it is a very good way. And it was in the beginning of this century in USA by Cohen and his co-workers, and they used a very sensitive modulator where is the using the whispering gallium mode of the micro-resonator. You see, it is very small resonator, diameter only 3 millimeters, thickness is less than millimeter, and they used this possibility of coupling the light through the evanescent wave of the disk resonator and prism. That means here is a one of realization of this device. Here is a prism, here is a disk and prism, here is a light, here is a light after the interaction with radio frequency, and they obtain the modulated optical signal, what can be optical processing to use. And but what is interesting that this is the resonance fixtures of this disk, and what is interesting that only two companies in USA can prepare these type disks. They are very sensitive for the microwave interaction with the light. Here is the metallization, and light is whispering gallium modes, that it is directly on the way of the light, what is propagated in the disk. And only two companies can prepare this type of devices because it is very difficult. Complexity of lithium-ion microdisk resonator preparation and complexity precision tuning of the distance between the prism and micro disk. And this gives us idea by using the paper of Giorma in 2002 that there is an analogy between the disk resonator and Fabry-Perot resonator. And we have suggested to use the not disk construction but the plate construction. Here is the mirrors. That means it's Fabry-Perot resonator. This is a fiber, and light is coming from the laser, enter to the fiber resonator, and here is a metallic plate, and it, this device is prepared from the lithium neobat, and it's possible, and we investigate the possibility to application of this and obtain that this can operate, and it has don't need prism elements, and the construction is rectangular, no need preparation of this disk resonator, what is very complex. And for the proving this application, we make modeling, analysis of optical characteristics of this resonator. We see here the transmission spectra of this resonator, and here you see the field distribution. When we have a transparency point, the optical field is localized inside the lithium niobate. When we have no propagation, the field cannot propagate, penetrate in a resonator. And here we see that the change of permittivity of lithium niobate in the seven position after the comma, we can have a change from the full transmission to the no transmission, and here is the for the wavelength. That means if the electromagnetic field is calm, the peak is change this position from the full transmission, we are going to the full non-transmission. And we also made the electro-optical interaction of Fabry-Perron resonator. When the light is propagated in Fabry-Perron, we consider that the light speed in the medium depends from this alpha coefficient, what is the nonlinear coefficient of lithium niobate, and here is the electric field. Depending from the direction of electric field, it feel that there is a change of permittivity or index, and here we see that resonances will be at some frequencies 11, 19, 27 gigahertz. For example, here when the light is coming forward and back and the speed is changed symmetrically, that there is a no change, and here will be the zero interaction of electromagnetic field with the light. And when it is another point, we have some non-equilibrium, and in this case we have maximal interaction of electric field with light. And here is conclusion of this part of my presentation, that the obtained periodicities of frequency and maximal zero agreement with corresponding data for the micro disk. That means we have obtained the agreement with micro disk, fulfilled like a macro disk, the sensitivity, everything, and advantages, what I said before. That means this is the first part of my presentation. If we have a time, I can have also to present about the terahertz, how to expand the terahertz by using optical.
I think you can continue with the terahertz.
Yes. Then thank you. If any questions to related to this presentation, I am ready.
What is the difficulty with the microring manufacturing when you saw
The difficulty is coming from this. You know, it is very small, and it is prepared from the lithium niobate. It is special cut on the axis because it's crystalline, and they will cut it to prepare it. And after, by rotating, they will make very smooth and curve, special curve, but long, on the both sides, on the side of this ring. Mm-hmm. Because the light is propagated as a whispering gallery, that means it's interacting to the border of this disk, and any roughness will bring that the light is called out. the quality factor is made low.
So what is the surface roughness? It's like better than lambda over 10 or even more?
It is much less than lambda. Okay. It should be much less. Mm-hmm. And you will see that when we are speaking about the whispering gallery, that is total internal reflection. When we have a total internal reflection, the some part of light is go outside of this surface.
Yes.
And it is has a possibility very easy to escape.
Mm-hmm.
And the roughness will be much better than we have, for example, for the fibers. The fiber is 8 micron, and the roughness is less than 1 micron or half micron. Here will be much better. And this polishing will be very better. That means here is important to have very high quality factor, because we would like to have a time that electromagnetic field interact with light.
Mm-hmm.
Light will make many circles when because there is a more than 1,000 difference between the frequency of gigahertz and there is a 200 terahertz.
Mm-hmm.
That means more than 1,000 difference, that it can make maybe million circles to feel that the electromagnetic field is changed permittivity.
Mm-hmm.
That means it's very complicated to prepare. Of course, I am not sure that the fabric or construction is prepared or not, because in Armenia we have only possibility to model, but not to prepare nothing. And it is only some suggestion to escape these problems, but I don't know how it's realized.
But you are making crystals, right, in Armenia?
Yes, we had. And now we have also.
Because I study in Bratislava and we had a cooperation with Armenian University. So I visited Armenia and we had I think technology from you to grow KDB crystals.
You are correct. I worked in the Institute of Lazerain Technica, yeah. Laser Techniques. And we have a big holes for the growing the crystallized granite, sapphire, and garnet sapphire, and different other crystals by using the special some ovens. But unfortunately, it is energy consumers, and we have only now the production of sapphire.
Mm-hmm.
Because
mm-hmm.
sapphire is using for the military purposes mm-hmm. now. For the head of rockets, it is very good. It is transparent, and it's possible to prepare and sell. But only sapphire, but not garnet.
Mm-hmm.
You are correct. It was under our university.
And you are still making the young lasers, picosecond lasers, because we got one from you as well, those days.
Yes. In this institute, we have a small part who are making some transportable lasers.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay. This is pulse lasers, like neodym.
Yes.
1.02 lambda micron. They are making, not so much, but they are mm-hmm. making still. But the crystals, they are buying.
Oh, okay.
Not they are.
Thank you.
Yes, you are welcome. In Armenia, I can show this institute, maybe you was there, a very big institute,
yes.
More than 1,000 scientists and laborers were there, but now only 50.
Thank you very much. And you will continue with different presentation, or you have it behind?
No, different one.
Different, okay.
I only two.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm.
I presented this it was a presentation in Warsaw, but very related to this photo. Here is the terahertz range. It's between the infrared and microwave. It's very interesting what is the terahertz and what we can do with these systems. They expected some unusual applications and some possibilities for communication. I will describe detail in forward. In the first, I would like to say that we will know that terahertz has a very big attenuation because the vapor or water is absorbed very strong terahertz. That means when you have a dry air or if you have some object without water, you can expect the propagation of terahertz. But when you have water, you cannot propagate. For example, here is the visible light, you see there is a small attenuation. Here is a microwave, small attenuation, but very big attenuation for the terahertz region. And this is a big restriction that we cannot use it for the far communication, like microwave or visible light. And the important one is how we can excite, that means generate terahertz. The originated is was some here is tunnel diodes. It is semiconductors with specific p-n junction. What can give us some terahertz region, but low frequencies, maybe 700 gigahertz. 700 gigahertz. No. The next one is diode of GaN. This is also semiconductor devices. What can give us also some 100 gigahertz. But sometimes they are not so some good because there is a noise also. And the interesting one, what is related to today's presentation, it is microwave interaction photonics. It is a generation but using semiconductor and optical parts excite the terahertz. And this is a very promising one because we can use it. For example, here, if you have a semiconductor, and you have here metallic parts, and here you have a gap, and if you put laser pulse in this gap, you will have excitation of carriers, holes and electrons. And they are, of course, would like to go some direction. Here is a voltage you can put, and they are give the radiation related to the dimension of the antenna. If the antenna is very small, some microns, you will have terahertz of some region of frequencies. And here is the same so-called photoconductive effect. That if you have femtosecond laser, if you have a beam, and here is a semiconductor, you have antenna, you have some voltage that you can take. You are using this gap like the excitation of usual antenna. In antenna, we are bringing the cable to both metallic ones, and here is the femtosecond laser create the holes and electrons, and the voltage is directed then through one and two other arm of antenna, and you have the emission of terahertz. Here are other possibilities that by changing the shape of antenna, you can obtain some directivity or large directivity. It is voltage antenna, it is large bandwidth, and here will be low bandwidth. And here is another possibility, what I told you, that if you are using two lasers with short a small difference between the frequencies, the difference of frequencies can be lie on the terahertz region, and the semiconductors will be give us terahertz as a result of heterodyne. That means two frequencies, small differences between the light frequencies, and these small frequencies give us the terahertz. Here is the explanation of this effect. If you have two lasers, very close frequencies, they are beating. The beating you influence on a semiconductor, and the envelope of this beating is terahertz. That means it's a very now wide used possibility to obtain the terahertz radiation. India is also the same. And very important to know how to check the terahertz radiation, because we have no some useful detectors. Here is the one of beginning, it is so-called Golay cell, would detect that there is a radiation. This radiation, where is the Golay? Oh, I lose it. Okay, excuse me. What is the Golay cell? Golay cell is the chamber, closed chamber, and there is a lens, the possibility to put the electromagnetic radiation into this chamber. And in this chamber there is a some very flexible some plastic. And when the magnetic radiation is come to the chamber, it heated the gas inside the chamber, and this plastic is changed the shape. On the plastic there is a mounted small mirror, and light is coming to the mirror and indicate that there is a plastic is changing shape. That means it is not a frequency selective detector. And now I would like to talk to you about the possibility to obtain the radiation from this semiconductor. When optical pump is coming to semiconductor, they possible to radiate electromagnetic wave terahertz, but will be very well if we have a fabric structure. What will be directed the terahertz on the some direction perpendicular to the layers and will be collected there. And for this we consider the possible construction of these mirrors and of the structure. Here is a semiconductor, here is a mirrors of silicium or two, and it makes us the electromagnetic modeling that when we have a low permittivity layer just near the semiconductor, we have very good possibility to radiate. It is electromagnetic modeling, what is in agreement with the experiments, not our. And here another one that it is a Schottky diode. Here is optical light, and here we have a detection, and we have terahertz some system what is permit to obtain the terahertz radiation. This is a very promising one, but not widespread. It is a cascade tunneling lasers. They are very difficult to prepare. In USA they are working on it, and it's also considering like a prospective generator of terahertz. And here is a very advanced one, that surface plasmons. When we cover the surface plasmon or metallic with some materials, it is possible to obtain terahertz radiation. As we know, in surface plasmons, the field is confined near the surface of metal and have very big amplitude. And this high amplitude gives nonlinear effect, and we have terahertz radiation. It is also prospective possibilities to excite terahertz. Oh, here is the Golay cell picture, here is a chamber, here is a window, here is a plastic membrane, and here is the optical system that detects that membrane is changing its position. Excuse me for this. And here is detector, that is semiconductor detectors. They can be made frequency selective and are preparing now for the different part of terahertz. And here is emitters and detectors, what is before. And here is a frequency spectrum of terahertz generated by these optical waves. And here I would like to say about the application of terahertz. That means here if you have a sample, you can obtain this spectrum And it's very important, for example, if you have a living or dying leaf, you will obtain different spectra. Because in living you have water, in dry you have no water, and the spectrum would be different. And it is very important for the medical application. If you buy the drugs, you can obtain the spectrum of the normal drug, and the garbage you will detect without opening the plastic. That means if you have some contra product, you can obtain TerraGas spectrum without opening on the conveyor, and you can know that is okay or not. It's very useful one. And also it's possible to obtain the TerraGas spectrum from the body, and it can be detect some changes in comparison with healthy and ill person. And also it is very good for obtaining the information from the skin, because the skin is not so much liquids in the skin, blood, and from the tooth, because there is no water there, also very good pictures given for the medical applications. And here is the device for the checking the skin by the spectrum. And here is a possibility to have LIDAR, that means they analyze the some fire on the distance by the spectrum of terahertz, forward and back. And also it is possible to see something inside. If it's plastic, you don't see what is inside. You can see if there is no water, you can see what is inside the covered some device, but not metallic, on the plastic. And you can check also the thickness of the some not water consisting some paints or some devices, composite materials. You can check very easy the spectrum. And also for the security reasons, you can see what is inside under the cloth. And here is a well-known figure that the persons in the TerraGas range. And I can say that here is in the post security and in the airplane security, they are using the TerraGas also, because in TerraGas you can see some materials, which is prepared in these materials. What about the telecommunication? It is prospective only for short range communication by the close some area. It is also good, it is approaching to the optical wireless communication. It is possible to have terahertz communication, but it is on the process. I am not sure that it will be so successful, because Wi-Fi is very good. Thank you for your attention.
Dear Professor, thank you for both presentations. And if there is any question related to these topics, Jack. Yes.
Could you please tell me the principle of cancer detection by using terahertz waves?
Unfortunately, for cancer detection, we can say only the skin cancer detection.
But the breast cancer detection?
This one, for example.
Next one.
This one. That means if on the skin there is some change, mm-hmm. it is possible to check what is it mm-hmm. very fast. Mm-hmm. And but if it is inside deeply, we cannot see. Because the propagation is only the thickness of skin.
Yes.
Okay. It's for melanoma, for the skin cancer, it is applicable. Mm-hmm.
But previous slide?
There was a written...
Yes, the breast cancer detection. Well, it was shown like that, so I asked.
It is,
maybe it's impossible, I think.
I think it's impossible. Mm. Because in breast, we have a lot of blood.
Mm. Okay, thanks.
Maybe it's a mistake. I don't know.
Any other question? technology. Thank you one more time for your presentation. And this was the last presentation of the...